Cheers.
Supposedly him, I don't know.
Thank you.
He's done it.
Thank you.
nice and tight.
Oh! Oh!
Would you believe it? Harvey Smith turns over.
Coming down in front of you is number 3, the
at the age of 9 years old, would you believe?
Looking to slip it on the inside. Poppy runs wide, Abby does go through, but oh, and it's still close, it's still side by side then. And they exit, and now watch this as they come down towards us. Poppy Stewart looks across his nose. I've got more top speed, look, I'm accelerating away, and Haylock does not have an answer. And we're on the last lap, and so Jared Duncan is on the far side of the race course in boat number 9, but now Haylock on the inside, Stewart on the outside, so this is going to run, I think, till the end, but we'll take Jared across. But I'm still watching this second and third position battle at the moment, and well, lose your money on, because boat number 11, Abby Haylock, the most experienced driver, trying to, I don't know, outmaneuver Poppy Stewart, but here's the checkered flag anyway, and congratulations to Jared and Duncan, as we watch Abby Haylock then. Watch this, the final turn. And does it pay off? They aim towards each other, almost like the red arrows then. But it's Poppy Stewart, excellent defending. She's been watching her dad, hasn't she, in the Formula 2. So Poppy Stewart collects the second position, but that was a good scrap from a new driver. And
Abby, she's there waiting for the gap. Right, gone for the inside, but I think Poppy Stewart, oh, this is tight. This is very tight, but he's got this tight strong going on speed. Now he has to do around the outside, so he's continually changing the position from that rear gearbox. Now, this time, using, I think, the front runner as a cushion, a nice, clever move there. Jared Duncan became the cushion there. And because Jared really put himself in the position that Poppy had to back off, then that allowed Abby to just get the slingshot through on the within there a lot of handicapped times. But since the computer shows that didn't happen, what we do now at the moment is that their efforts, admirable as they are, unfortunately, won't count. That does still lead on to this last lap. Safely. As you can see, water surface very, very uneven indeed. It's the edge of concrete. Apron and bounces back, so you get twice the number of waves each successive lap. So as the laps build up, so the water begins to really take on a boiling situation. The top turn. So using the top turn, I guess, as the demarcation buoy. So, Ashton Bedford, who is from 87, Gracie Bay, from 34, Bill Bedford, 26, top 32 is a playoff, Big George Elmore. Then we have 8 and 21. Very close to each other, 57 and 24. Hence, of course, Steve Aldi and Madeline Duncan for the young man from the local club. In second, 34, Bill Pettibald. Then we have George Elmore in 5. Then we have Susan Palin in 26. And in 87, we have Gracie May Sampson. A little bit of a cushion for these five. Next, it is Dan Hibbert, ninth position. Safely round the wary turn. But the leaders already around the right-hander and heading towards turn three. With him and fourth place man. Joseph Haylock. Now, as the position was in second chain, yes it has in fact, and it is George Elmore who has now got that second position too. Paul Pickford now back in third. Joseph Haylock 26 still running in fourth. For that first mark one for beginning the North Lincoln. So I have 21, Brad Wilson, and finally 24, Madeline.
Number 24, Madeline Duncan. Start the first 6 laps. Slows it down enough, Gracie then gets that advantage into that wary turn, takes it very tight. Ashton Bedford, number 3, trying to avoid George. Catch Bradley, now look, 21 on the back straight. Bedford coming up to the back of Darrell Hibbs.
Of course, Bedford racing here at his home club, what can he do? Racing Sampson then on the inside of Steve Holley as they go down towards the very turn. But Steve, and the thing is, I don't think Steve will realise that he started early. So we're all in this close. Wow, that was a bit close there, those two. So Steve then almost getting collected by Penfold, I think.
Movement there for Ashley Penfold. That boot becoming completely airborne. Ashley, well, I'd say he's proved to be an incredibly good driver since he's taken to this GT30 class. Really pushing that lead to the ragged edge. Let's see, the race leader already around the top turn.
Trying to get on the outside, Joseph Taylor on the outside of Darrell on the inside. Well, I think he does go for the slingshot. So Joseph Taylor goes for the slingshot then. Darrell Hibbert, it's all ineffective because he's effectively second from last because of the early start. But look at that gaggle of boats, Elmore then.
Engine, I think it's
head towards us and give them all away.